BoxingBoys.com here with Jorge Capetillo. Brother, probably you're probably the most talked about person in boxing these last 7 days since the Tyson Fury fight. Walk us through basically the fight. I feel like, you know, obviously things took an unexpected turn.
Yeah.
You know, obviously nobody anticipates a cut of that magnitude.
Yes.
Two of them actually.
Yes.
I know you're primarily a trainer. However, you know, you've said it that you need to know the ins and outs, because sometimes as a trainer working with fighters, you guys can't afford a cut, man.
Yes, that's
so
true.
Obviously Tyson Fury, you know, has the money, but what, you know, walk us through what happened last Saturday night.
You know what? It was a tremendous fight. First of all, I got to praise God for allowing us to have the victory. I want to thank Ben Davison, who's doing a tremendous job with Tyson himself, for including me in the team. And, man, it was a dramatic fight, you know, bleedy, dramatic, you know, in the Mexican Independent Weekend, you know, versus a guy who's undefeated, number four in the world, a Southpaw, man. And, you know, there's always when there's an Orthodox and a Southpaw, there also was clashes, but in this case, it was a punch. And on the beginning, Tony Ruiz came to us and told us, you know what, this is an accidental headbutt. So in our understanding was if the fight stopped, you know, before the fourth round, would be just a no contest. You know, it was an accidental. It was no points the dog, nothing. You know, it was not a foul. But then in the fourth or fifth, Bernardo came to the corner and asked us, "Did you guys know it was a legal punch?" Because they not right now in Vegas, there's a new the replay. So Bob Ben and the crew, they checked the replay and they know, they see there was a legal punch. So Bernardo came to the corner and said, "Did you guys know?" And we say, "No, they told us it was an accidental headbutt." Say, "No, it was a legal punch." So everything changed in that moment, bro. Everything changed.
It almost seemed like Tyson's, like his attitude changed at that point. You know, when the doctor came into the ring, looked at it, a lot of people at the end of the fifth had Otto Wallin up 3-2. Regardless, it was extremely close. What was Tyson's mood? What was his, you know, basically his thoughts in the corner? What was he saying to you guys?
You know what? He was really, we make sure to make them feel calm. Me and Ben, we were just calm. We were just let him know that everything was okay. There was no panic, no stress. Everything, it was working. So he can develop. He can do his job, you know. But he understand that with the cut, he has to go and fight. What he wanted to do is make sure that the Otto feels like he was pressing too, because he feels like if Otto just came to us and jumped into us, maybe, you know, we'll be open right. more wider the cut.
Now, since the fight, you've received nothing but positive feedback from any and everybody in the sport of boxing.
Yeah.
What has that meant to you? Because I mean, maybe you could disagree, but I feel like this is probably the you know, the biggest point in your career as far as, you know, the respect and the credit that you've been given for your work in the corner.
Yeah, and you know, and I want to thank you, because you were one of the first one right in the press conference. Then, you know, you asked Ben Davison about myself, about my work, and about my career, and I was in that moment, I was feeling very, very proud. And I just want to say thank you, man, because
absolutely,
you start everything, and then everybody came and they start one, you know, one question to another, and they start realizing that I was doing a good work in the corner, you know. And I'm very thankful. You know, there's few, you know, this is a perspective sport, so everybody had a different perspective from my work. But at the end of the day, you know, we got the win. That's what it matters.
Now, before the fight, earlier in the camp, there was videos of your son who's here tonight in the ring shadow boxing with Tyson.
Yeah.
That video's also gone viral on the internet.
Yeah.
What's that mean to you, to not just as a trainer, but as a father, to, you know, have your son in there with the world champion like Tyson Fury?
No, it means a lot, man. I feel very blessed. I praise God for this opportunity, for allowing me to be in this position. You know, I'm very thankful with the team. I'm very thankful with Ben Davison for including me in the team, with Tyson Fury to, you know, just to bring me to his team, to be around them. It's an amazing, you know, it's all about love in the gym, working hard, discipline, you know. He got a lot of, Tyson has a lot of love for the people, for the kids, and he lost my kid, man. So I don't have nothing but gratitude, you know.
Absolutely. Now, I do gotta ask, there was reports that Sunday morning you went to go check on Tyson.
Yeah.
And that he was extremely grateful for your work and what you contributed in the corner on Saturday night, that he actually gave you, you know, maybe a bit of a reward, you know, to show his gratefulness for what you did. Is there any truth behind that?
You know what? What happened was on Sunday morning, you know, I called a team to check him out, you know. You know, he's my fighter, you know. It was my cut, so I just want to make sure that he was okay, you know, that the stitches were good, that he was resting good. I just went to see how he was doing. And the moment that he saw me, he was so happy, so grateful, came to me, gave me a big hug, and said, man, you make this possible. And right there on the spot, just give me a bonus, you know, for gratefulness. And I feel very, 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 very blessed, man.
Now, this is your second time working in Tyson's corner. From what you've spoke with the team, does it seem like even if he's not fighting in America, even if he fights, say, in the UK, for example, or if he's fighting in LA, does it seem like you will continue to work with Team Fury?
Yeah, you know what? Because I think I put all my effort, you know. I think that I did my job, you know. The job was done. Everything was good at the end of the night, you know. So yeah, they're happy with my job. They're happy with my person. You know, so I feel I'm part of the family, you know, I'm part of the team. And like I told Tyson, you know, he has my loyalty to the full team, to him, to Ben Davison, and I'm here. And I'm here for them.
Now, I saw when you guys were in camp, you guys had a cookout, some carne asada.
Si.
And he had the you know, the corridos
and
stuff. And we saw a very... very entertaining ring entrance from Tyson Fury. Hey, have you been teaching him at all any Spanish or, you know?
Yeah, a little bit, man. You know what? He got a lot of sympathy for the Mexican people. You know, he feel like we're really similar, you know, similar people, you know. We are a person for family, hardworking people. So he feel very, very sympathy with us. I feel very sympathy with them, you know. And he was just like, oh, you know what, Jorge, I wanna carry your colors with pride, with honor. You know, I got a lot of respect for Mexican fighters, for your heritage, for your culture. And listen, man, to see a man that come from the other side of the world, man, 7'7", man, you know, showing some love, showing some respect, fighting for the Mexican pride, man, it makes me feel, ooh, unbelievable proud, you know, and I'm thankful and I'm happy, you know.
Now, lastly, obviously that cut, we'll keep him out of the ring for a while. There was talks of him fighting in December. That's obviously not going to happen.
Yeah.
February is a... The date, at least right now, in place for a Wilder rematch. What are your thoughts? Do you think he will be ready in February?
If the cut heals well, I think that cut will be for 60 to 90 days to heal. Pero everybody is different, you know? Every person is different. So I think if he heals fast and is very, very sealed, probably he'll be able to start working probably in 70, 90 days, you know? And if you see we're in September, October, November, by December, he'll be okay, like in the middle of December, just past the Christmas and stuff, and it's up to him, up to the team, you know, the doctor to give him the green light, and he'll be ready to war. He wants to fight on that day.
Now, obviously, Wilder still has to fight Ortiz.
Yes,
they haven't even officially announced it, but the word is November 23rd. So, given what just happened to Tyson, is there any concern from the team that maybe Wilder could get hurt, could get cut, and that maybe that fight's gonna have to get postponed even more?
Yeah. You know what? And Bob Arum, he was telling like, hey, they gotta see what happened in this fight and not fight on November. But it's up to them, you know. Already Tyson win, you know, a win is a win. You know, it was probably not his best performance, but I'll tell you this, he's a man that he can box, and he showed that he had the braveness, he got the guts, so he can stand with any man, toe by toe, and just get the fight. So absolutely. I hope Wilder and Thursday get well. I hope Wilder, can get the win, and all the people and the fans can see the rematch that everybody is expecting and waiting for.
So you do think that Wilder gets the win against Ortiz?
Wilder?
Yeah, do you think he beats Ortiz
rematch? You know what? It was a tough fight. The first one, I see the fight, Ortiz almost knocked him down, but I see Wilder more young, more strong, more right. aggressive. So of course, it's in the on the A side, that's what I'm trying to say,
And lastly, December 7th, Saudi Arabia, the rematch.
Yeah.
The Mexican American Andy Ruiz,
yes.
Shocked the world. Yeah. June the 1st. The rematch against Anthony Joshua. Break it down for us. How do you see that fight play out, Jorge?
You know what? I'll tell you this. To be honest, Andy is very, he had a lot of hand speed and he can crack. Anthony already know the Andy can punch. So if Anthony Joshua don't change his strategy, he don't box, he's gonna get knocked out again by Andy Ruiz, man, for sure.
Jorge Capetillo, thank you very much for your time, brother.
Thank you, brother. Truly appreciate it. I appreciate your time.
The man of the hour right now in the sport of boxing, the most talked about person in boxing right now today. Thank you.
Well, if you enjoyed the video, feel free to hit the like, subscribe, and share. As always, if you want to support us to the next level, head over to the patreon.com/theboxingvoice. We have tons of exclusive from Border Wars, Entitled, betting shows. The list goes on and on and on. But in addition to that, if you guys have questions for fighters, trainers, and promoters, this is where you can submit them. We will run out, get these questions answered, and put it back on the show just for you guys. Appreciate it. Peace.